Livets livet, så vil jeg være en verden full av roser og champagne og deilige mannfolk.
Alle har sin drøm. Altså, livet jo fullt av vidunderlige tilfeldigheter i alle fall. En av de oppstod i Central Park.
Her kom jeg tilfeldigvis til Central Park for å gjøre et intervju med Anne Torsvik, og så sitter en mann akkurat på den steinen jeg skal intervjue hun, og så sier han at dette hans plass. Og så vandrer han litt rundt her. Her står han.
I'm just trying to tell that we just met 2 minutes ago, and what I said, I think you're here for some reason, because I don't believe in coincidences. And your answer was?
My answer was, I just finished a book called Beyond Coincidence, meaning that I don't believe in coincidence either.
No. You have written that book, and you have written a new book now.
Yes, my new book is on out-of-body experiences. It's totally different, because the out-of-body has become a center of communication with life after death. Because what happens in the near-death experiences is that we have outer body, meaning something separates our body and we see this. Now, in our laboratory where I am, we're studying what this means as a part of the communication of a world unknown to us. And of course, the great debate is there a reincarnation or just one life after we die, or is there something? Primarily, I had my own near-death experience, and I have to say that.
Wow.
And it was very mystical.
What happened?
I died. I actually, they had to revive me, and it took them over an hour to
what
bring me.
What was the
I had 105 experience? Temperature, and I died, and I separated from my body and went into a tremendous illumined world.
Light?
Light. It's more, it's not, we call it light, but it's not light. It's just unexplained.
Did you go through a tunnel? I've heard pictures of tunnels.
No, the difference in mind, because a lot of people have asked me, it was like a line, and there were a lot of people waiting on one side of the line trying to get to the other side, and I just went over to the other side. And there were questions that I wanted to ask about the afterlife, which I got the answers to. What is the afterlife? And the afterlife is actually the way we are. Death accepts us as we are. If
oh,
we believe
beautiful.
In heaven, then heaven is inside of us. If we believe in a hell, it's inside of us. If we believe in anything, it's inside of us. So we actually create our own reality, and that sort of blew my mind.
Ja, det ikke bare amerikanere som har nær
livets livet, så vil jeg være en verden full av roser og champagne og deilige mannfolk.
Alle har sin drøm. Altså, livet jo fullt av vidunderlige tilfeldigheter i alle fall. En av de oppstod i Central Park.
Her kom jeg tilfeldigvis til Central Park for å gjøre et intervju med Anne Torsvik, og så sitter en mann akkurat på den steinen jeg skal intervjue hun, og så sier han at dette er hans.
To revive me, and it took them over an hour to bring me.
What was the
I had 105 temperature, and I died, and I separated from my body and went into a tremendous illumined world.
Light?
Light. It's more, it's not, we call it light, but it's not light. It's just unexplained.
Did you go through a tunnel?
As a part of the communication of a world unknown to us. And of course, the great debate is there a reincarnation or just one life after we die, or is there something? Primarily, I had my own near-death experience, and I have to say that.
Wow.
And it was very mystical.
What happened?
I died. I actually, they had
plass. Og så vandrer han litt rundt her. Her står han. I'm just trying to tell that we just met 2 minutes ago, and what I said, I think you're here for some reason, because I don't believe in coincidences. And your answer was?
My answer was, I just finished a book called Beyond Coincidence, meaning that I don't believe in coincidence either.
No. You have written that book, and you have written a new book now.
Yes, my new book is on out-of-body experiences. It's totally different, because the out-of-body has become a center of communication with life after death. Because what happens in the near-death experiences is that we have out-of-body, meaning something separates our body and we see this. Now, in our laboratory where I am, we're studying what this means.